Well, let's get more on this now from Andreas Theophanous, I beg your pardon. He's the president of the Cyprus Centre for European and International Affairs. He's also a professor at the University of Nicosia, joining us via Skype from there. It's good to have you with us on the NewsHour. Let me get your sense of how the situation is set to play out. How likely would you say a de-escalation is at this point?
I think it's serious. At the same time, we have to understand that this is not the first time it has been happening. There is a record of such climate in the past, and all the time we had attempts to de-escalate. We have to understand that the root of the issue is the fact that Turkey is a revisionist power and seeks to redefine borders. And this has been the cause of the problem. Erdogan himself does not conceal the fact that he wants to change the Treaty of Lausanne. Obviously, Greece, which has over time followed a flexible policy towards Turkey, trying in the past to encourage its European orientation, hoping that Turkey will change, this did not lead into any result. Instead, we had an escalation on the Turkish side, and it seems that there is a limit to what, you know, to how much Turkey can push Greece. And in the last few months, Greece is declaring that although it seeks, it is committed to a policy of peace and cooperation in the area, at the same time, it cannot accept the violation of its inalienable rights.
So where do you see this going then? Is this likely to head towards a full military conflict at this stage? Because Turkey's made noises that it wants to have dialogue, it wants to negotiate, but it also considers this part of the Mediterranean its territory. If Greece is saying this is my territory, where does this go? Because all sides are talking about they want to negotiate, but no one seems to be prepared to do that.
OK, let me put it this way. There is international law and there are treaties. There is, I want to start from first principle. Does Turkey, you know, would Turkey respect the Treaty of Lausanne? I think if we hear a yes from Turkey, I think this is a very positive side. Does Turkey respect the territorial integrity of all its neighbor states? You see, we have a record of Turkish behavior. It's not only in Greece and Cyprus. We have seen Turkish adventurism in Syria, in Iraq, in Libya recently. So the perception that exists not only in Greece and Cyprus, but also increasingly in other countries as well, including major powers of the European Union, is that Turkey it wants to use its military power to impose its own terms of peace with quotation or without quotation. We here in Cyprus, we see, we are very much aware of the Turkey of record. If we go back in 1974, when Turkey invaded the island, it declared that it is doing so to reestablish constitutional order and to protect the Turkish Cypriot community. In practice, it destroyed the constitutional order. It has occupied 38% of the island, and it is suffocating the Turkish Cypriot community as well by more and more settlers, to the extent that Turkish Cypriots today are a minority in the occupied northern part of Cyprus. And at the same time, Turkey does not recognize the exclusive economic zone of Cyprus. I mean, we have to understand that, you know, Turkey is a revisionist power. It has military power and it wants to use it to define its own terms. It seeks hegemony in the Eastern Mediterranean and the broader area.
Okay, it sounds like this isn't a conflict.
Statements by the Turkish president and Turkish officials themselves.
OK, it sounds like this isn't so much a conflict about hydrocarbons in the Eastern Mediterranean. It seems like it's about more than that, and it's about territory and who controls what. And these arguments have been going on for decades. Given this, do you think it's possible to have an independent broker involved in any kind of negotiation? And who would that be?
I think in the past there were ideas that the issues could go to the International Court of Hague. On the other hand, you know, I mean, you have the European Union, you have NATO, you have the United Nations, but when we are negotiating, we have to take certain principles into consideration, in the sense that before we enter, what are the issues to be discussed? And the first issue I raised it before, I'm repeating it now, it's the following. Does Turkey recognize the Treaty of Lausanne?
Okay.
Number one. Two, the other, if we come to Cyprus, I mean, Turkey does not recognize the right of the Republic of Cyprus to exist, yet it invokes clauses of the Treaty of Establishment to pursue its policies in Cyprus. It has to be consistent. And it uses the Turkish Cypriot community in Cyprus to project its own strategic objectives in Cyprus and in the area. And in relation to in the past, when we had similar instances, the European Union leaders and the United States and NATO would just make statements encouraging the two sides to be flexible, to see the negotiations and all that. But there were no effective sanctions against Turkey. So Turkey, there was no cost for Turkey in relation to its assertive and aggressive policies.
Okay, I'm afraid I'm going to have to draw this discussion to a close, Mr. Theophanous, but fascinating to get your views. Complicated discussions ahead, one can assume, but for now, we'll leave it there. Thank you so much for talking to us. Andreas Theophanous joining us
from
the University of Nicosia.